During the bilateral talks, Nabanja briefed the IOM Director General that there is a need for a strategy to have durable solutions in the management of refugees in the world. Nabanja acknowledged the support the United Nations International Organization for Migration gives to Uganda in the running affairs of refugees.
If we gave a chance to permanent solutions, either looking at these softwares, mm-hmm. and have these people to feed themselves.
So they have the ability to
they
farm?
Can do farming.
Yeah.
Can do farming, but they, you know how, for example, Wamaja is?
Yes, yeah.
This is Islam.
Yeah.
The sanitation facilities.
Yeah.
Sometimes when I go to those areas, I feel like, what do we do?
I know.
If you are a mother, you really feel it.
And young children. Right, growing up.
Nabanja briefed the Director General how Uganda was the first refugee hosting country in Africa by hosting over 1.6 million people. Nabanja asked the UN to adopt sustainable means of feeding refugees so that they are empowered to produce their own food and construct permanent structures to reduce the pressure on land through the numerous structures for accommodation.
Yeah.
So I'm looking at durable solutions. Can we at least get at least some apartments instead of wasting all this money to software? Apartments, free the land because it's crowded. This one puts a hut here, ramshackle huts, grass thatched houses, scattered all over. So that land could be used for production.
The Director General, UN International Organization for Migration, MEE POP, says that they are looking at Uganda as a model in refugee management and promised to use the Kampala Declaration during the NAMS summit to further address issues of refugees.
So the Kampala Declaration on Migration, Environment and Climate Change is one of my most important priorities to succeed, because I think it's a model for the world.
Of course.
And I know, the last I saw, we have 35 members who've signed on. We will do everything we can to support that effort to get to all 55. And then I'm hopeful we can get something similar in other regions.
Nabanja also appealed to Amy Pope to support Uganda in its interventions to rescue some migrant workers that are stranded in Myanmar, Burma.
We have stranded Ugandans.
Where are they located, do you know?
Some of them are in Myanmar.
Burma. Oh!
They keep crying on my phone almost daily. These are highly educated Ugandans.
Do they go to work in call centers, or what? Do you know how they got banded up?
Most of them are graduates.
In are they IT specialists? Or?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So you know we have porous borders between Uganda and Kenya. So these young children or young men and
young
women,
adults,
with first class degrees, are lured into better jobs. And so they are trafficked through Kenya, Nairobi, and they go to Sairam. They are promised that they will get good jobs.
In
Bangkok. You can't know, because our East African community, you don't need a passport to go to Kenya.
The duo also promised to meet to further engage and find ways of sustainable management of refugees. Nabanja is in Italy leading the Ugandan delegation at the Italy-Africa Summit, and she is representing the head of state. Story compiled by Ismail Kasoha for the news.